Good morning again everyone, and 12th class business studies. And yesterday we started the chapter with the definition, meaning and process of organizing we did. So I'm going to unmute one or two students to tell me the steps of the process of organizing. Okay, so Manmeet, I'm going to unmute you. Yes, Manmeet. Wait a minute. Okay, Nishtha, I'm going to unmute you. Yes, Nishtha.
Yes,
yes, Nishtha. Yes, beta. Please tell me, what do you mean by organizing? Yesterday we did the topic.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, organizing.
Manmeet, you can wait for 1 minute. Okay. Yes. Yes. Start, beta.
Ma'am, organizing can be defined as identifying and grouping various activities.
Okay. Identifying and grouping only.
And ma'am, bringing together all the and human resources.
Okay. Only the human resources.
Ma'am, financial, physical, human, ma'am, all yes. The resources.
Yes, very good. All the resources. And establishing reporting relationship. So organizing can be defined as identifying and grouping different activities in the organization and bringing together all the physical, financial and human resources. Very good. Yes. Next, Manmeet, I'm going to... I think, Manmeet, you have left the class. So now I'm going to unmute you, Naman. Please tell me the process of organizing, Naman Jain. Yes, Naman.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Tell me the steps of process of organizing which we did yesterday.
Ma'am, process सबसे पहले तो ma'am उसका identification होगा, काम का सब काम सबको बांटा जाएगा ma'am.
Yes. Then afterwards.
ma'am departments बनाए जाएंगे, सबको job दी जाएगी, मतलब सबका अलग अलग department होगा.
Yes. First step is known as identifying and division of work. Second step which you are telling me is known as departmentalization or grouping of activities. So yes, third step.
और मैम उसमें duties दी जाती हैं.
Yes, assignment of duties. Yes, next fourth step.
फिर मैम जो भी मतलब organize हो जाता है उसकी मतलब क्या उसका result आया उसको report करते हैं.
No.
Fourth.
रिपोर्ट नहीं करते हैं बेटा. इन फोर्थ स्टेप वी आर एस्टेब्लिशिंग द रिपोर्टिंग रिलेशनशिप बिकॉज मेनी पीपल आर डूइंग. यस प्रियांशी, वेरी गुड. मेनी पीपल आर डूइंग वर्क टुगेदर, सो वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट हु इज द सुपीरियर एंड हु इज द सबॉर्डिनेट, हु विल बी टेकिंग द रिपोर्ट फ्रॉम होम एंड हु विल बी गिविंग रिपोर्ट टू होम. Because when this thing will be clear, then only their roles will be clear and there will be no confusions in their mind and they will be not wasting any time. Okay. Am I clear? Okay. So today's topic is, so let's get back to today's topic. Today's topic is, yeah, these already we have done all these slides and now I have come to today's topic, that is the benefits of benefits or importance of organizing. So what is the importance of organizing? Why organizing is important for the organization? What are the benefits which the managers may derive by performing organizing function? So all these are the benefits you can see in the slide, and one by one I'm going to explain all the slides. Okay. First, benefit of division of work. I am reading all first, then I will explain. Benefit of division of work and specialization. You all can explain this point very well because this is related to principle of division of work. Clarity in working relationship, optimum utilization of resources, adaptation to change, effective administration, then development of personnel, and last but not the least is expansion and growth. Okay, so all these are the benefits, and I told you earlier also that every function of management have its own importance and no function of the management is least important. So in board examination, at least one importance will be there in 5 or 6 marker question. Okay. So earlier also I have told you 2-3 points of importance, general points or common points like optimum utilization of resources. This is the common point which you can write in all the importance points of all the functions importance. Then the expansion and growth, it is also the common point. So some of the points helps in achievement of organizational goal. If you don't remember any other point, so you can fit this point in all the importance of all other functions, helps in achievement of organizational goal. Okay, so I'm going to the first point, that is benefits of specialization, we can say. So you can see in the picture, and it's a mouth-watering picture actually. So specialization means like, when we are assigning the duties to the persons in the organization, then again and again, the same person is performing the same duty because that duty is particularly assigned to him. Assigned to him means every time he has to perform the same duty. So when the person is performing one duty again and again, then that person will be the expert in performing that particular task. Expert, expert means professional. So he will be having the benefits of division of work and specialization. The organization will be having the benefits of division of work and specialization. Each and every person will be specialized in doing that particular task. So in this manner, the benefits of specialization, and what are the benefits of specialization? Increase in the speed of work. We can say the efficiency. It will increase the efficiency as well as the effectiveness of the employees, which definitely will result in the perfection as well as the higher profits of the organization. Because as in organizing process, we have studied that the first step is division of work. And wherever division of work is followed, then two benefits are certain. Benefits of specialization. Specialization will lead to the expertise and professionalism, and which in turn will lead to the increase in efficiency and increase in effectiveness of the employees. Second point, clarifies authorities and role. So in the last step of organizing process, we have assigned, in the second last step, we have assigned the duties. And in the last step, we have established the authority responsibility relationship. Authority responsibility relationship here means that who is the superior and who is the subordinate, from whom he has to take the orders and to whom he has to give the orders. So jobs clearly define the jobs. So this step of the organizing process clearly define the jobs in the organization. The jobs are defined on the written documents, which is called job description. Each person's job is mentioned on a written document, and that document is known as a job description. So it's a very important one marker question, define job description. So job description is a document, written document, which explains what exactly has to be done in every job. Means what are the responsibilities in each job and what a person is supposed to do in that particular job. And also in that job description, the role of person is also very much clarified, that he is superior to whom and he is subordinate to whom. So this is known as line of communication. This line of communication is very much clear. So if the line is clear, then it will be helping in the fixation of the responsibility. Suppose I am assigned a job, and job, it is mentioned on the job description. Then if I am not doing that job, then I am responsible. I cannot deny my responsibility because each and everything is in written form. So I have assigned the duty, I have taken it, and if I am not completing it, then I am responsible. So with the help of this assignment of authorities and responsibilities, we can fix up the responsibilities of the employees, and definitely it will create a role clarity in their mind. It will create a role clarity in their mind. Role clarity means there will be no confusion in their minds. Everything is clear to them and they will be without wasting any time. They will be just doing their work. Okay. So we can say that it helps in creating a hierarchical order. Hierarchical order means chain of superior and subordinates, and thereby enabling the fixation of responsibility and specification of the extent. Clear? So authority and responsibility are two elements which cannot go alone. They go hand in hand. One side authority and the other hand side is the responsibility. Third importance is the optimum utilization of resources. It does not matter. It's a very important quotation. It does not matter how many resources you have. If you don't know how to use them, it will never be enough. You can see in this picture, this person is having so many of the ladders. But he is, suppose he don't know how to use a ladder and he just want to cross the wall. So, but he don't know how to use the ladder. So that's why he is not able to cross the wall. It's a very good picture which says everything about the resources. Suppose an organization is having good amount of resources, good amount of furniture, good amount of building, very good and expert and efficient employees, human power is also efficient. Then the machines are of good quality, raw material is also of good quality, but the management don't know how to use the resources, how to assign the duties. In that manner, whole of the resources will be wasted. The overall objective of the organization cannot be achieved. So, or in organizing, again, you have to relate it with role clarity. If the role clarity is there, so organizing leads to the proper usage of all material. I told you all material, whether it is physical resources or financial resources or human resources. Proper usage. Proper usage means no resource remain idle or no resources are wasted. Each and every resource is properly utilized. Utilized here means they are used in the production process and they are giving us benefits or the returns. So again, you have to relate this point with the role clarity or the assignment of the jobs. When we are assigning the jobs to each and every person, then it will be definitely avoiding the overlapping of the work. Overlapping of the work means duplication of the work. No work can be done in a duplication of matter. So it also makes possible the best usage of the resources. So organizing helps the organization to avoid the duplication of the work, helps in preventing confusion and minimizing the wastage of resources and efforts. And in this manner, all the resources, physical resources, financial resources, and human resources will lead to the proper and optimum utilization, reduced wastage, and increased low cost, and the leads to low cost and high profit. So next point is adaptation to changes. So we all know that the business environment is uncertain. There are so many changes in the business environment, like in technological environment, in economic environment, social environment, it keeps on changing. So organizing helps the enterprise to adjust itself according to the changes in business environment. Because business environment keeps on changing, and if organization is not adopting those changes, then it will be difficult for the organization to survive in the changing environment. So it has to adopt the changes. So how organizing helps to adapt the changes? That is the through organizing suitable the organizing the management suitably modifying the organization structure. So what is the organizing structure? This is the next topic. So there I will be explaining that organizing structure means the hierarchical order of the pattern of the job position. We can say ki in which pattern the jobs are arranged, the positions are arranged in the organizing. So suppose the organizing is having three departments, one for the cosmetics, one for the footwear, and one for the garments. Now organization wants to diversify it more. So it has decided to launch the leather products. So without affecting the existing three departments, it can easily add up one more new department for leather products. So it means suppose the leather demand is changing. So that's why it has thought of making good amount of profit by selling the leather products. So in that case, it can adapt itself according to the change in the taste and the preferences of the consumer, according to the change in the demand pattern of the consumers. Now suppose we can relate it to the present situation. Due to the COVID situation, many businesses have entered in the new lines. Could you please tell me what are the new lines in which the many businesses have been entered? Yes, Harshita, I am unmuting you. Please tell me. Yes, Harshita. Please tell me, beta. Yes. Which type of lines adaptation to changes many businesses have started with the new products nowadays due to the change in the environment? Yes, Harshita, please speak up. Many students have given me answers in writing. Very good. Yes, Harshita, you are not able to speak up. Please tell me. Yes. So, Mithali, I'm going to unmute you. Yes, Mithali. Harshita, why you are not speaking up? You are giving me answers in chat. Yes. Harsh Bhatt, I'm going to unmute you. Harsh Bhatt.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, what are the new lines for the businessman according to the change in the business environment?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, COVID-19 ki situation ke relate karke.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am. मैम आईटी सेक्टर में भी डेवलपमेंट हुई है क्योंकि मैम लोग घर पे अब काम करते हैं और अब डिजिटल मतलब डिजिटली सारी चीजें जो होती थी उनमें ग्रोथ आई है.
यस, व्हाट एल्स?
और मैम
यस तोषित, यस तोषित, आई हैव अनम्यूटेड यू. You have given me very good answers in chat, so I just want to speak up your answer.
Ma'am, business are adopting like medical equipments like PPE kit and ventilators.
Yes, very good. What else?
Mask, face shield, and
face.
And,
very good. Mask, gloves. You have written in chat all these. Medical equipments, PPE kit. So many of the business units which were not earlier producing all these things, sanitizers, they were not greatly demanded. But now the businesses have add up all these product in their product lines. So this is adaptation to change. And how they have adopted it without affecting their present structure of business. They have just set up a new department. One department for sanitizer, one department or division for PPE kits, one for mask. Many business units have started producing it. And Prime Minister Modi has given the slogan for like, uske liye unhone bola hai ki aapda mein opportunity. Opportunity ko kya bolenge Hindi mein? Yes, export bhi kar rahe hain. Very good. Many businesses have also starting exported it. Means जो भी क्लाइमिटी नेचुरल क्लाइमिटी है ये या जो भी है उसको उन्होंने एज अ अपॉर्चुनिटी ले लिया है. अपॉर्चुनिटी मीन्स इसमें भी उन्होंने प्रॉफिट मेकिंग स्टार्ट कर दिया है. बहुत सारे बिजनेसेस हैं हु हैव स्टार्टेड मेकिंग ऑल दिस थिंग्स. यस अवसर, वेरी गुड प्रियांशु. आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू रिकॉल द हिंदी वर्ड्स. आपदा का आपदा इज कंसिडर्ड एज अवसर. प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी हैज यूज दीज टू वर्ड्स. आपदा को अवसर में बदल दिया है उन्होंने. आपने चैप्टर 3 बिजनेस स्टडीज में पढ़ा भी है. Identifying the opportunities and getting first mover advantage. If you remember, I told you in chapter 3, importance of business environment. Identifying the opportunities and taking the first mover advantage. Have you remembered, you all? So you can relate all the chapters if you are going in deep. Okay, so adaptation to change. So organizing helps the businessman to adopting the change because just to adopt the change, businessmen can design the organizational structure, because the structure is flexible. Anytime we can add up the more departments, and anytime we can delete the departments which are not giving us good amount of profits without affecting the working of other departments. Okay, so the next is the effective administration. Effective administration, how the administration will be effective. Again, the same point, role clarity. Jobs are assigned to each and every person, and there is a very much clear authority and responsibility relationships. And this helps in avoiding confusion and duplication and enables proper execution of work. Thus, managing the enterprise becomes easy, and this brings effectiveness in the administration. When the roles will be clear in the minds of the employees and they will be doing all their work smoothly without any confusion, then there will be no confusion, as well as it will help to the management to take the decision more faster and the effective decision. So organizing help in effective administration by providing clear description of the jobs. Clear description of the jobs means their jobs are clear. It is very much clear in their mind that who has to perform which task. This helps to avoid confusion and duplication. Management of an enterprise thereby becomes easy, and this brings effectiveness and efficiency in the management. Okay, next point, development of personnel. Personnel here means the employees. So could you please, any one of you, if interested, can raise hand to explain this point, to give your opinion about this point, that how the function of organizing develops the personnel. Develops means increasing the skills of the personnel. Yes, anyone is interested? You can raise hand, please, if anyone is interested in this explaining. Just take initiatives. I'm not going to allot you any marks here, but we are just discussing the point. So you all are free to give your opinion ki how we can relate this point with organizing, like in class. So I don't want my class is just a monologue. So no one is interested. I have seen many times that whenever option is given to you, then you people are not interested. So instead of giving your answers, you start giving me answers in chat. Yes, Anshika, I'm going to unmute you. When you can give answer in chat, then why not? Yes, Anshika, I have unmuted you, beta. Anshika, you are giving me answer in chat, then why you are not speaking up? Yes, tell me how development of the personnel, how is it possible, development of the personnel? Please tell me. Yes, Anshika. Yes, Anmol, you want?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Anmol, if you are interested.
मैम, डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल में मैम क्या होता है? मैम वर्कलोड जो मैनेजर्स का वर्कलोड होता है मैम, वो डिवाइड हो जाता है. जैसे मैनेजर्स डेली अपने सबॉर्डिनेट्स को मैम काम देते हैं, तो इस वजह से ना मतलब मैनेजर्स का वर्कलोड डायरेक्टली उनके सबॉर्डिनेट्स पे चला जाता है, जिसकी वजह से मैनेजर्स को अपना ज्यादा टाइम मिल जाता है ताकि वो स्ट्रेटेजी पे ज्यादा काम कर सके.
Yes, they will be having more of time to focus on the core activities or the important activities of the business. Yes, this you want to say?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
So, any other student also can raise hand if interested. Yes, Shubhangi, where are you? Yes, wait a minute. Yes, Shubhangi, I have seen your hand now. Sorry. Yes, speak up better.
Yes, ma'am. Development of personnel in a management when where all the personnel are given personal training of either of languages, because that is what their job demands. So in a way or two, the management grooms every personnel in person.
Yes, very good. Because in organizing, they are given the jobs, they have assigned the jobs, and to complete that job, sometime they also need training and the different type of courses which the organization makes easy for them, arrange for them. And one more point is there, which Anmol told, that in organizing, the manager is not doing all of the work himself, because management is the art of getting things done from others. You all know this thing. Management is the art of getting things done through others. So manager has to take work from others. So he has to also assign some of his work to his subordinates, and subordinates will be working for him. When subordinates will be working for him, he will be having ample of time to focus on his main activities or the core activities. So in this manner, there he will be able to enhance his skills, to become more professional, to become more expertise. So it helps in development of personnel by delegation, and assigning this task to others is known as delegation. This is a very important concept which we will be doing in the later part of the chapter. In delegation, the superior is giving some of his tasks, less important tasks, to his subordinates. And subordinates are doing the work of his superior, and by doing so, he is reducing his workload, and it will give him opportunity to the subordinates to utilize their talents. Even the subordinates will be also satisfied, because they will be doing the more important task, which is beyond their job level. So they are doing the task of their bosses. So they will be having a deep motivation that our bosses has shown trust in us and they have allotted the task. So it will lead to the self-satisfaction among them. So the last point is expansion and growth. So expansion and growth, when the organizing is there, so you have to relate this point with two earlier points, that the role clarity as well as the optimum utilization of the resources. When resources are optimally utilized, it means no wastage is there. It will increase the efficiency of the organization. When jobs are clearly assigned to them, it means there is role clarity. When role clarity is there, then again there will be no overlapping of the activities and there will be no wastage of the resources. So organizing always promotes growth and diversification of an enterprise. Growth means, so could you please anyone tell me what is the difference in between growth and diversification? Are they both same or are they both different? Yes. Yes, please tell me. Anyone who is interested, tell me growth and diversification. Yes, Divya, I am unmuting you. Yes, Divya. Yes, Divya, please speak up. Growth and diversification. Could you say that these both two are same? You are not able to speak, Divya. Yes, Anushka Bansal, I am unmuting you. Yes.
Yes. Ma'am, growth of the business enterprise may be that in the increase in the turnover of its operation.
Very good.
Over the time period.
Yes, very good.
And
the new branches. Very good, Vaibhav, you are also giving me correct answer. Yes. What
and
else?
The increase in the variety of the product offered by the business, that is known as diversification.
Yes, very good. Increasing the varieties or the number of products. Could you give me any example, beta, of diversification?
For example, any food manufacturing company which is producing only chips, they are now producing chocolate also.
Very good. Good example, Anushka. Very good. Clap for you. Yes, Thira, I have unmuted you. Yes, Thira.
Yes.
Please give me any example of growth. Growth, she told that increase in the turnover of the business, increase in the profit, increase in the sales. It means growth.
Yes.
Yes.
Ma'am, for example, a company has opened new branches three states or has opened new.
You are very much correct, beta. Continue with this.
Is using new technology, for example, opting for innovative ideas.
Hmm. Yes, very good. So growth means if you are adding up more production, more sale, and you have opened the new branches, it means you are growing. And diversification means you are entering in the new product lines. Earlier you were producing only chips. Now you have started producing chocolates, as the example given by Anushka. Very good example. So it is the example of diversification. So with the help of organizing, the business may lead to expansion and growth, and diversification both. So it helps in expansion and growth as well as in diversification, because organization provides the framework within which an enterprise can expand and grow. And that framework is actually known as organizational structure, which is our next topic, which we'll be doing in next class. So all the organizational decisions are taken within that framework only. So if we want to add up a new product line, we can just add up a new division without affecting the work of other divisions. Through the organization, management can multiply its strengths. It is through a sound organization structure that many small firms have grown and become big. So when you will be explaining this point, then you have to talk about the organization structure. Like the example is given about, the good example is Reliance. Earlier Reliance was only in petrochemical industry, but now it has also entered in the grocery items. So this is the example of diversification. Okay, and now it has also launched its own app, just like we are conducting the class on Zoom app. So similarly, the Jio Meet is launched by Jio, Reliance. Okay, so we can take the example of Wipro. Could you please, anyone? Originally known as Western India Vegetable Products Limited. This is the full form of Wipro. Western India Vegetable Products Limited. And it was established only in Maharashtra. It is an Indian company and it's a very big company. In 1945, and earlier it was only producing only the edible oils, vegetable oils, which we can use in cooking. Then the main products were sunflower, vanaspati, and 787 laundry products it was producing. Over the period, it has diversified into the field of IT. Now it has also entered in IT industry and home care products. So this diversification is supported by the strong organization structure. We can easily grow, we can easily expand or diversify. It only depends on our organization structure. Yes, Anmol, very good. Mother Dairy Saksham has given the example, and Anmol has given the example of Tata Company. Very good. All these are the Indian companies. So today we have done only one topic, that is the importance of the organizing. The first point, I am doing the recap, benefits of division of work and specialization. Second point, it brings the clarity in the working relationship, clarity in working relationship. Third point, optimum utilization of resources. Fourth point, adaptation to change. Yes, Deepak, Dabur is also a good example. Fifth point, effective administration. In this point, again, you have to talk about the role clarity. Then sixth point, development of personnel. And the last point, last but not the least, expansion and growth, which is the very important point. Okay, class, I'm ending class here. Thanks for being patient listener. Okay, bye to everyone. Goodbye. I'm ending here meeting.